Hello everyone. In my recent Dear List video, I trashed on Captain America a little bit, so I wanted to show that in the right hands he can still be a beast and is more than good enough to destroy all content in this game. I have all the timestamps in the description below for anyone who just wants to see the gameplay. However, before we begin, I want to just throw a quick heads up: if you are a beginner to the game, this build is more aimed for endgame players, so you may not understand some of the terms I'm using, and while I have tried to explain everything, there are things like what the stats do and things like that won't be in this video. This build is more aimed at people in the endgame, and so I won't be covering the basics in this video. So, if there is anything in this video you don't understand, or if you have any questions at all, please leave them in the comments and I'll be happy to answer them. I'm going to be going through all his gear so I can explain why I use it and where I got it. I generally run two builds: a melee Brooklyn Brawler build for getting through missions, then a powerful glass cannon ranged build to take on any bosses. So, I'm going to show you both with some gameplay at the end. For the Brooklyn Brawler build, I'm going to get into some power level 170 max group size harm room gameplay to show how powerful he can be. For anyone newer to the game, there isn't even any power level 170 enemies in the game at the time of this recording. So, if he can easily beat hordes of enemies that are 20 levels above him, he can take anything. Then for the ranged build, you will see me taking on the OLT Super Adaptoid solo to show that he can still output some decent damage by simply having the right stats. Jumping into our Brooklyn Brawler build, the first piece that people generally call the melee slot, we have the Faultless buff inserts. This gear only recently released with the War for Wakanda update and can be found in any mission in Wakanda. Just a warning though, these can be quite rare, and when I was farming for it, I went through close to 200 pieces of gear before I got a single one. However, they are totally worth it. What makes these special is you can activate the damage buff on your melee critical hits, which works super good in our build. It lets you just go crazy with your ultimate and not needing to stop and throw your shield or rely on reactive buffs, which is great. It can also generally roll with super high stats, with this piece almost have 50s across the board. I like having the sonic element on light combo finishers, as it will generally apply with one hit against most enemies and allows Cap to recharge his heroics faster, and is great for fighting the new claw enemies, so this should work well in the upcoming raid. Next, we have our second piece we call the ranged slot, and I have this crazy exotic on my Captain America. I got this from the Monica villain sector, but you don't necessarily need this exact piece, but let me tell you why I use it so you know what you are looking for. For starters, it has two stats that I want: Might and Valor at 70 and 67, which is super high. On top of that, we have a proficient buff, which granted we don't need that much because of our faultless buff we have in our first slot, but it's still nice for fighting those annoying flying enemies. Then we have the cosmic element. While this build doesn't have any focus on battery damage or even elements in general, cosmic can still be useful for some of the bigger enemies, as any enemy with the cosmic status on them will take 20% more damage and heal us when we are attacking them. Then finally we have the targeted Tachyon Surge. This perk was just nerfed last month and basically does nothing now but lets you apply status easier, so in other words it's not important at all. So, in other words, you could use any piece here that just has good stats and your preferred element for fighting some of the tougher enemies. Next, in our third slot I call the defense piece, we have this reactive protection chest plate. The defense buff is crazy powerful, and it always blows my mind how many builds don't take advantage of this buff. I'm not joking when I say I have a similar piece of gear for every character. I might not always use it on them for every mission, but having it as a backup to switch to for when things get tough is an option I want to have, and I can't recommend you have one of these ready for whatever character you plan to take into the raid. Let me show you why. In this clip we are only fighting 150 enemies, but look at our health as we are taking damage. Captain America's Rally Cry ability combined with the damage buff gives us so much damage resistance, it's crazy. Just look at all these hit we are taking and they barely do any damage. I also want to point out that this build doesn't even have over 100 resolve or resilience, which just makes the damage reduction even more impressive. It also scales up to the 170 enemies you will see in the gameplay later, or this clip here, where attacks that would usually one-shot me, they are barely doing half my health. So back to my specific piece, we have a reactive defense buff which almost has a 1 in 3 chance of activating, but honestly it feels like more. Then a second one that has almost a 2 in 3 chance to activate for when we do get critically injured. So, in other words, this one chest piece adds a whole truckload of survivability which you will definitely need when getting up and close with some of the more dangerous enemies. Finally, in our fourth slot, or our heroic slot, we have probably my worst piece and the one I'm actively looking for an improvement for. The stats are kind of low. We could have a different piece that has close to 350 stats instead of my 2. In a perfect world, I would like to replace this with a Jarvis Barrier exotic that has Might, Valor and Resolve. All the perks on this piece are just nice to have and not really necessary. The damage buff on takedowns is good, as we will be doing a lot of those, but at the same time, just having the Faultless from the first piece is enough. The same thing applies for the Berserker Spark. While it does activate now and again, Cap has so much heroic regenerating abilities that it's not that important. All that's is followed by 2 Might artifacts, but as always, just use the artifacts to make up for stats you couldn't get on your gear. As well as your preferred artifact, I use the Nord Stone on this build. Here are my stats for this build. We are going as high Might as we can with 50 proficiency, which is more than enough, as we will be activating our damage buff all the time to make up for our lack of crit chance. 158 Valor, which in all honesty I could get up to 200, but 158 has still been fine for me. Finishing it off with around 90 Resolve and Resilience, which is more than enough when combined with our defense buff. I'm not going to go through why I'm picking all the skills, as most of them are pretty self-explanatory. So, I'm just going to flash through them. I would recommend you just pause the video so you can go through in your own game to see what they all are. The only really important ones are in the ultimate tree that allows us to keep Brooklyn Brawler up forever. However, why this build is great for taking on regular enemies, it sucks against bosses, and what I do is very simple. So simple, I'm not even going to explain any of these pieces, as all I'm doing is equipping all my gear that has both precision and valor and changing my ISO to precision. None of the perks matter here apart from my ranged piece having a damage buff on ranged crits. You can also see me swapping my skills around to focus more on damage. There is absolutely nothing special to what I'm doing here. I'm literally just stacking damage and nothing else. Again, if you don't want to use it and go pure glass cannon, you can equip the defense buff chest piece and bang, you will be tanky again. However, if you are confident in your dodging and you do want to go full glass cannon, you will be able to do things like this.
Back. Please just hang on. How about a rain check?
I got your back, Avengers. Yeah, I got him on the rope.
Get in my sight!
So, do you have it, a Captain America build that can fly through all content with ease? What more do you want that a character that can solo the super adaptoid and take on hordes of 170 enemies? As a final showcase and to put this build to the test, I have gone into the custom harm room and set all the enemies to power level 170 and set the group size to max. There is no modifiers and no hazards. I'm only going to show the last wave from each of the groups. I did this to save this video being longer than it already is. Please note, setting the enemies at 170 greatly reduces the damage numbers, and I have done one extra room against 150 enemies at the end, so you can see what the build looks like against the level of enemies we have in the game now. As a reminder, I have put all the timestamps in the description. Finally, before we begin, a quick tip: when playing this build, try to keep Rally Cry and your captain's defense buff activated as much as possible. You activate the captain's defense buff by pressing the right trigger and triangle or Y. Sorry PC guys, I'm not sure what that translates to. This will just keep you as tanky as possible, so you can just go ham with Brooklyn Brawler, making sure to keep activating your takedowns when possible. So let's get into the gameplay so you can see what a beast Captain America can be.